afternoon and there's nothing to eat.
Oh, there's some leftover Chinese food.
Ew, too greasy.
Pepperoni pizza?
Too fatty.
Curry chicken?
Too spicy.
How about a block of ice?
Yuck. I hate water. Just forget it. I'm not hungry anymore. Good idea, Liz. Only 142 shopping days till Christmas.
It's just a little something for Todd.
Liz,
it's a Lakers jacket. I ordered it a month ago before Todd and I broke up. It just arrived. I have to give it to him.
Liz,
it has his name on it. What am I going to do with it?
I'll keep it. I'm sure one of these days I'll date a guy named Todd. Liz, look, I know this isn't easy, but you're going to have to move on. Todd's not worth it. Besides, he has one huge flaw.
What's that?
He broke up with my sister. What you need is to find a new boyfriend.
I don't know, Jess. I don't think I'm ready.
Not ready to date? That's like not being ready to breathe. Are you sure we're related?
That's true.
So anyway, the House of Chic was having a special. If you spend enough money, they give you a free gift.
Well, how much did you spend?
Just enough to get an umbrella and a little makeup case. Okay, and a tote bag, a shaving mug, a pair of bedroom slippers, a travel pillow, and a Fabio calendar.
Gee, I can't believe your father was mad.
I know. I mean, I did offer to give him the umbrella. And what kind of thanks do I get? He puts me on a budget. Talk about cruel and unusual punishment.
It isn't so bad being on a budget. Most of the world does it.
Yes, and most of the world is tacky. I can't believe I'm even talking to you. You cannot possibly comprehend the huge economic burden of being well-dressed. Cheryl, help me explain to her the high cost of looking good.
Actually, I don't spend much on clothes. Mostly I shop in secondhand stores.
You don't mean déjà worn.
Uh-huh.
Oh, it's disgusting.
This dress is from the 60s, and it only cost me $3.
Hmm. See, there are worse things than being poor.
Really? You could be poor and short.
Whoops.
How late is he?
A little over an hour.
Want me to rough him up? Please say no. Listen, Liz, Todd's going through a tough time right now. Getting cut from the team at Fairmont was a huge blow. Basketball is his life.
That's the problem. He's forgetting about his friends, school, and me. I'm trying to understand what he's going through, but he keeps pushing me away.
Well, if it makes you feel any better, last week he blew me off to shoot baskets after basketball practice. These days, it's the only thing he wants to do.
Still shouldn't have stood me up.
I know. I'll talk to him.
Well, I hope you have better luck than me. Bye.
Hey, you heading over to Wilkins' party tonight?
Oh, yeah. It's been great.
Excuse me. Are you talking about Todd Wilkins?
Yeah. You should really come by the party, though. You know, it's going to be a real rager. It's anything like last week's party.
Oh, yeah. What's your name?
Liz.
Liz? Todd's Liz?
Yeah, I guess.
I thought Liz was that redhead Todd was with the other night.
Oops.
You were right.
Of course I was.
Right about what? Me and Todd. It's over, and I need to move on. Besides, we were getting too serious anyway.
Duh.
Jess, I think I'm ready to date.
There's the Wakefield spirit.
I know I'm gonna regret saying this, but can you help me?
This is the moment I've been waiting for.
I've taken the liberty of separating the boys at Sweet Valley High into different categories of desirability. Now, these guys are warm, sensitive, and have high GPAs. Losers, feel free to pass them on to Enid. Now, these guys have hot bodies, great cars, and cool hair.
That sounds good.
I think I'll keep these for myself. You can have my rejects. This pile contains boys that'll be perfect for you. Good-looking, dependable, nothing fancy. But I think you'll be quite pleased.
This sounds great, Jess, but I just want one date. How are we supposed to sort through all these?
All we need is a system.
No, no, thank you. Scott Trost, Jr., 16, red Corvette, Thursday the 4th at 7:30.
Got it.
David Prentice, 17, senior All-State running back, 2 years. And a row, Friday the 5th, 8 o'clock. Yes. Oh, I've got a gorgeous 5'6" blonde. No, no, we're not giving away any free football phones. And there.
Hello, Lance. Darling, do you still have that cute little black
portion? Do you like sushi?
Winston, labor class.
Hi, Mr. Frankel. Winston, can I have a word with you?
Sure. But I just want you to know that the red dye in the drinking fountain thing was totally not my idea. From the very beginning, I said it was childish and irresponsible and basically just a really bad idea. And it would not only make a fool out of you, but it would make a fool out of the rest of us.
I just want to know how your friend Todd is doing.
Fine, I guess. Why?
Because he hasn't been in my class for the past week, so I assumed he must be sick.
Yes, he is. He is sick.
But you just said he was fine.
Well, fine considering. I mean, his fever is down to 104, and he's no longer delirious. So, you know, considering where he was, he's fine. In fact, full recovery is expected.
Uh-huh.
I'll tell him that you were asking about him. As a matter of fact, I'm going over there later to bring him some soup.
Watch this.
Can I go now?
See you later.
Hey, Jerry.
What's up?
Is Todd still in the gym?
Todd Wilkins? I haven't seen him in weeks.
What are you talking about?
He never rejoined the team.
You're kidding. Every time I want to do something with him, he says he has basketball practice.
I don't know what his problem is, but he really let us down.
So, how do you like my new eyeshadow and mascara?
How did I know you weren't going to be able to stick to your budget?
Oh. Contraire. I didn't spend any money. I just went to the makeup counter at the mall and used all the free testers. Hey, free perfume. I'm impressed. Oh, and have you seen these things? It's amazing. You just cut them out of the paper, you take them down to the store, and they actually lower the price for you. It's like free money.
I believe it's called a coupon.
Coupon?
Coupon.
Oh, coupon. Like in Grey Poupon. Isn't that great? Coupon. Coupon. Coupon.
Hey, Carl.
Hey, man. Want to go a little one-on-one?
Me? No, I don't think you'd want to. It'd probably be more like one-on-zero. Hey, have you seen Todd?
Yeah, he was just here a little while ago. Too bad about that school in Vermont.
Yeah, I know. He's taking it pretty bad.
Yeah.
Any idea where he went?
Nah, he took off with some guys.
All right. Thanks a lot.
No problem. Hey, Winston.
Yeah.
Really hope you can find him. Seems like he can use a friend right about now. Catch you later.
Come on, man. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let me try it. Come on. Just let me do it. Come on, baby. Come on now. Come on, guys, quit fooling around.
Chill out, Todd. You just make sure no one sees us.
It's cool. It's cool.
Bingo!
All right.
Guys, no, split. Hey, come on, let's go.
Go away.
Floor it!
Todd!
Doing?
I want to wear this on my date.
Oh, it's full of lint.
Really?
That's a good idea, Liz. Can I see it?
Sure.
Ooh, this is nice.
Jess!
Now, let's get you ready for your date.
I love that sweater.
Oh, cut it out. You've got like 84 of those, don't you?
But I feel...
Liz, forget about your old boring clothes. Wake up. Dating has changed drastically since the early 90s. It's a whole new ball game out there. And frankly, you're just not ready.
Thanks.
Lucky for you, we're here to help.
We?
Know what you are,
dance to me. Now what you choose and what you do, oh, something's happening to you. She
Everything okay with you, man?
Fine.
I gotta talk to you. Look, I saw you at the school the other night.
So?
With the Camaro.
You better get your glasses checked, Winston, because you didn't see anything.
I know what I saw. Todd, you could go to jail.
I'm telling you, you didn't see anything.
Where are you going? Scott's here. I thought I'd go downstairs and go on a date with him.
You're serious? If I wasn't here, you'd go downstairs right now, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Liz, let me tell you how this works. You have to make the guy wait. It's a fundamental fact of dating.
But I'm ready. I've been ready for 45 minutes.
All right. All right. Go down there. Amateur.
So I guess this is it. I'm so nervous.
Don't worry. Just remember what we talked about, and you'll do fine.
You know, the last time I was on a date, other than Todd, I think we ended up burning ants with a magnifying glass. Do boys still...
Not as much. My little sister's all grown up.
Jess, I was born 4 minutes before you.
He had no idea we were laughing at him.
I'll take that when you're ready.
Oh, thank you. I had a really good time tonight, Liz. You want to catch a movie next weekend?
Okay. Okay? Okay? Liz, we went over this. Never, ever accept a date immediately. It makes you look like you have no life. Play a little hard to get. Come on.
Actually, next weekend is no good. I have to wash my dog.
The whole weekend?
He's a really big dog. You ready to order?
Yes.
Liz, Liz, Liz. First rule of dating. Guys love it when you take charge. Order his meal for him. And stop slouching.
Have you decided?
We'll have the shrimp fajita for two.
Actually, I don't think...
No.
Leave it to me.
Thanks.
Thanks a lot, Liz. I was trying to tell you. I'm allergic to seafood.
I love this place. Have you eaten here before?
No.
The food is great. Thanks. Aren't you going to look at the menu?
No. I'll have the number 3.
Great. I'll be back with your drinks.
So, my cousin got me tickets to the state playoffs. A bunch of us are going. You do like football, don't you?
Quick, change the subject. Maybe he won't notice. Could you pass the guacamole? Shut up, Enid. Don't listen to her, Liz. This guy's gorgeous. Whatever he's into, you're into. If he likes snakes, buy a python. Tell him you like football. You're both wrong. It doesn't matter what Liz says about football. I'm much more concerned with these earrings. They do not go with this outfit. Get out of here.
Listen to me, Liz. I just want to know.
You can't take this anymore. Get out of here.
Check.
Let's see. I got 20 cents for recycled cans this morning. For lunch, we had free samples at the cheese shop. And this lamp was an absolute steal at 25 cents.
Yeah, it's worth at least 50 cents.
And we saved $2 in gas by walking 10 miles to the flea market. I only spent $3.75 today.
Why don't you check for loose change in my couch?
That reminds me. I already found 65 cents earlier today. And half a pack of gum. Finders keepers.
What are you doing?
I'm just gonna take some of these for later. Well, we better go to dinner now.
It's only 3:30.
We don't want to be late for the early bird specials at Captain Al's. They have an all-you-can-eat shrimp fest for only $2.99.
Lila, I can't take this anymore. For the past week, we've been to every garage sale in town. I've eaten 3 pounds of free cheese, and thanks to you, I'm the proud owner of 14 gallons of mayonnaise.
Hey, they were selling for a very good price. You come with me. Now! Jessica, dinner's on me tonight. I can't thank you enough for breaking my budget. Oh, I can barely even say it.
Well, I knew locking you in the House of Chic would break you. It only took a half an hour before you were charging up a storm.
And my father was more than happy to give me back my credit card. Especially after I pawned his heirloom cufflinks.
I'm just glad this ugly episode of your life is over.
And I pledge on this 6-ounce bottle of La Duche Ultra Hydrating Royal Jelly Eye Cream that I will never pay wholesale again.
And he filed his taxes with trees, right?
I think that was true.
It's terrible. Unforgivable. How could we have let this happen? Look at them. It's pathetic. She's just being herself. How fake. Who is that guy anyway?
I don't know. I think he was from the loser pile.
You realize she just messed up the whole system.
Ew. Winston, we can't eat this.
Ketchup, coming right up.
Excuse me. What's going on?
I'm really worried about Todd.
Look, Todd's a big boy. He can take care of himself. He's got to get over this basketball thing.
No, it's more than that, Liz. I saw him the other night at school. He's with some friends. He's trying to steal a car.
My God. He's really getting under control.
I know.
Hang here and order me a drink, all right? Thanks. Well, if it isn't the Wicked Witches of the East and West, I should get out of here before a house falls on me.
Hey, can I get some fries over here?
Oh, you want some fries, huh? I got your fries.
Yeah. Hey. That's it, Wilkinson.
Oh, isn't this cute?
Oh,
Little Miss Perfect and her perfect date. Gee, Liz, you should rebound pretty quick. Maybe you should try out basketball.
Maybe you shouldn't have quit, Wilkinson.
Todd, can we speak outside for a second, please?
Stay out of the way,
Wilkinson. Just a break, okay?
All right, Wilkins. We'll go this time because we got a history together. Get your act together, man.
Let go of me!
Hey, I just saved your button there, although I'm not sure exactly why. You're acting like a real jerk.
Get lost.
Look, you have to get over this, okay? Just get over it. You were cut from the team in Vermont. It doesn't mean...
Listen, man! You don't know the first thing about me, so butt out! I don't need you.
Hey, Ty, those are the geeks. We got some serious partying to do.
Yeah, let's go! I don't need any of you.